Hello, hello. How are you doing today? Fireworks, yes or no? Some yes, some no. My kitty cats don't like it too much. They kind of burrow in. Well, welcome everybody. We are going to be celebrating the USA today with Terry Orr. Lots of wonderful patriotic music. Next week we have Bill Peterson and his crew from Missouri Valley. They'll be playing fiddle music. So that's what we'll have here next week. So let's go ahead and get started with Terry Orr.
There we got it. Good afternoon. Welcome to the 4th of July show. We're here to celebrate our nation's 247th birthday with music. And the songs today are going to make you happy. They're going to bring back memories. You're going to have a sense of gratitude and probably inspire a little more patriotism, because I think we already have a patriotic group here. Now, running the PowerPoint today for today's show is my sister, Marcy Broyhill. Yes, she'll do a good job. And moving on, historians have cited that there is a direct link with war and music. Every war had rally cries, songs of home, songs of sweethearts. Generally, actually remarked that without music, there would not have been an army. Music is even credited with winning World War I. So today's show is a collection of some of the popular war era songs. But I also found and included some what we might call newer songs. And some of them were also requested. So that makes me happy to have a few requests. So we're going to start out, we're going to get ready for a parade. Isn't that nice to have a parade right here inside? Let me make sure everything is turned on right. I think I got it. We're going to give it a whirl.
I'm my Yankee Doodle Dandy, I Yankee Doodle Do or Die, a real live nephew of my Uncle Sam. Born on the 4th of July, I've got a Yankee Doodle sweetheart. She's my Yankee Doodle joy. Yankee Doodle went to London just to write a poem. I am that Yankee Doodle boy. This land is your land. This land is my land. From California New York Islands, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me. As I was walking that ribbon of highway, I saw below me that endless skyway. I saw above me that golden valley. This land was made for you and me. You're a grand old flag, you're a high-flying flag, and forever in peace may you wave. You're the emblem of the land I love, the home of the free and the brave. Every heart rings true for the red, white, and blue, where there's never a boast or break. Would all acquaintance be forgot? Keep your eye on that grand old flag. Keep your eye on that grand old flag.
Yeah. Thank
take a quick look back. Starting with the Revolutionary War, the British gave us something to sing about. In fact, they inspired a song that we still sing today. So let me explain. During the war, the British made fun of the disheveled American military, or the Yanks, but the Americans embraced the term, and their insult inspired the song Yankee Doodle. Historians have noted that the Americans played Yankee Doodle when the British surrendered at Yorktown, kind of like a retaliatory insult, you might say. So we know the song, we sang it growing up, Yankee Doodle. I think there are probably 90 verses to it, so let's do two. Yankee Doodle went to town riding on a pony, stuck a feather in his cap and called him Macaroni. Yankee Doodle, keep it up, Yankee Doodle Dandy. Mind the music and the step and let the girls be handy. There was Captain Washington upon a strapping stallion, giving orders to his men, there must have been a million. Yankee Doodle, keep it up, Yankee Doodle Dandy. Mind the music and the step and with the girls be handy. Now, looking back at the Civil War, a massive amount of music was written during the Civil War. Historians estimate 9,000 to 10,000 songs were published during that time. Songs like Dixie, Where Oh Where Is My Little Dog Gone, Beautiful Dreamer, When Johnny Comes Marching Home, The Battle Hymn of the Republic, and many more. There were also important songs already popular before the war. Many of these songs brought heartfelt emotions by soldiers on both sides of the conflict. Songs like Laurelina, The Yellow Rose of Texas, Orlie and the Girl I Left Behind. Out of so many songs, I picked two. I picked When Johnny Comes Marching Home and The Battle Hymn of the Republic. When Johnny comes marching home again, hurrah, hurrah, we'll give him a hearty welcome and hurrah, hurrah. The men will cheer and the boys will shout, the ladies, they will all turn out, and we'll all feel gay when Johnny comes marching home. The old church bell will peal with joy, hurrah, hurrah, to welcome home our darling boy, hurrah, hurrah. The ladies and the lassies, they with roses, they will strew the way, and we'll all feel gay when Johnny comes marching home. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. He is trampling out the vintage where the grapes of wrath are stored. He has loosed the fateful lightning of his terrible swift sword. His truth is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. I have seen him in the watchfires of 100 circling camps. They have builded him an altar in the evening dews and damps. I can read his righteous sentence in the dim and fading lamps. His truth is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. With songs like Praise the Lord and You're in the Army Now and Over
There.
Over there.
Praise the Lord and past ammunition. Praise the Lord and past ammunition. Praise the Lord and past ammunition, and we'll all stay free. Praise the Lord and swing into position. Can't afford to be a politician. Praise the Lord, we're all between perdition and the deep blue sea. You're in the army now, you're not behind the plow. You'll never get ripped for digging a ditch. You're in the army now, you're in the army now. You're not behind the plow. You may have fun, you son of a gun. You're in the army now. Johnny, get your gun, get your gun, get your gun. Take it on the run, on the run, on the run. Hear them calling you and me, every son of liberty. Hurry right away, don't delay, go today. Make your daddy glad to have had such a lad. Tell your sweetheart not to pine, to be proud your boy's in line. Over there, over there, send the word over there, that the Yanks are coming, the Yanks are coming, the drum, drum, drums everywhere. So prayer, say a prayer. Send the word to beware. We'll be over, coming over, and we won't come back till it's over, over there.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure those songs were sung over and over and over. Now, when we talk about World War I, we must include the great music of Irving Berlin. Now, Irving Berlin's family immigrated from Russia when he was just 5 years old. He became a citizen at the time of the draft, and he never believed that he would get drafted at the age of 30, but he did. Berlin was sent to Camp Upton in New York, and when he was there, he was asked to write a musical to boost morale, which he did. The musical was called Yip Yip Yap Hank. How he got that name, I do not know. Yip Yip Yap Hank. Berlin said there were a lot of things he didn't like about Army life, but the thing I didn't like the most was reveille. And through this song, you get an idea of his great sense of humor. Oh yeah, that picture. Look at what they did. They put the bugle inside a big megaphone there. Make sure it's loud enough, right? I've been a soldier for a while, and I'd just like to state, the army life is wonderful. The food here's really great. I live with 97 others in a wooden hut. I love them all, and they love me. It's very lovely, but oh, how I hate getting up in the morning. Oh, how I'd love to remain in bed. The hardest blow of all is to hear the bugler call. You gotta get up, you gotta get up, you gotta get up in the morning. Someday I'm going to murder the bugler. Someday they're going to find him dead. I'll amputate his reveille and stand upon it heavily and spend the rest of my time in bed. Oh, how I hate getting up in the morning. Oh, how I'd love to remain in bed. But then I'll get that other pup, the guy who wakes the bugler up, and spend the rest of my time in bed.
Thank you.
War II, we embraced some of the songs from England, and there was a lady over there that was real popular. Her name was Vera Lynn, and she had songs like The White Cliffs of Dover, When I Grow Too Old to Dream, and Bless Them All.
There'll be bluebirds over the white cliffs of Dover tomorrow. Just you wait and see. There'll be love and laughter and peace ever after tomorrow when the world is free. The shepherd will watch his sheep, the valley will bloom again, and little Johnny will sleep in his own little room again. There'll be bluebirds over the white cliffs of Dover tomorrow. Just you wait and see. When I grow too old to dream, I'll have you to remember. When I grow too old to dream, your love will live in my heart. So kiss me, my sweet, and so let us part. And when I grow too old to dream, that kiss will live in my heart. Bless them all, bless them all, the long and the short and the tall. Bless all the sergeants and WO1s, bless all the corporals and their blinking sons, 'cause we're saying goodbye to them all. As back to their billets they crawl, you'll get no promotion this side of the ocean, so cheer up my lads, bless them all. You'll get no promotion this side of the ocean, so cheer up my lads, bless them all.
Well, World War II also left us with some catchy, upbeat tunes that still delivered that heartfelt message. Remember the one, Don't Sit Under the Apple Tree? I'll bet you do.
Oh, don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me, anyone else but me, anyone else but me. Oh, no, no, don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me till I come marching home. Don't go walking down Lover's Lane with anyone else but me, anyone else but me, anyone else but me. Oh, no, no, don't go walking down Lover's Lane with anyone else but me till I come marching home. I just got word from a guy who heard from a guy next door to me. The girl he met just loves to pet, and it fits you to a T. So don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me till I come marching home.
Now the Western songwriters were also writing songs of freedom in their own little cowboy way. Excuse me, gotta move it further. There you go.
Oh, give me lands of land under starry skies above. Don't fence me in, Let me ride through the wide open country that I love. Don't fence me in. Let me be by myself in the evening breeze. Listen to the murmur of the cottonwood trees. Send me off forever, but I ask you please. Don't fence me in, just turn me loose. Let me straddle my old saddle underneath the western skies. On my cayuse, let me wander over yonder till I see the mountains rise. I want to ride to the ridge where the west commences. Stare at the moon till I lose my senses. I cannot look at hobbles and I can't stand fences. So don't fence me in. Don't fence me in.
Well, thank you. Now this next one is relatively new to me. It was a request that I had, and so I pulled it out, and I'm going to do my best to present this wonderful song to you. It's called The Old Army Hat, and it was done by Bill Anderson and Walt Aldridge. And you remember Bill's, what, Smiling Bill Anderson? Whispering Bill Anderson. And you can just tell this is kind of his flavor of music. And I hope you enjoy it, and I'm so pleased to be able to present it to you.
He came home to Tennessee, a young man at the end of 45. Only man of seven men in his platoon that made it back alive. He must have seen some tough times, but he never talked too much about all that. Put his picture and his memories in a cedar chest. Everything but that old army hat. By the time I graduated, the winds of change had blown across the land. They were burning flags and draft cards when they bothered to take some kind of stand. And we used to laugh at Grandpa like he was some old relic from the past. 'Cause he never left the house, thus he was wearing that funny looking worn out army hat. Every eye was all upon him, any time that he went anywhere. They whispered and they shouted, but you could tell that Grandpa didn't care. I ain't wearing this for them, he said. It's a whole lot more than that. For my buddies who gave everything, the least that I can do is keep on wearing this old army hat. He called me up one morning, said he'd seen it on the news on his TV. They've opened up a monument to World War II in Washington, D.C. I ain't getting any younger, and I wish someone would take me to see that. I couldn't help but think they're gonna laugh at you up there if you show up with that silly army hat. Two strangers both saluted as Grandpa walked up to the monument. One said, "Thank you, soldier, for a job well done." The other said, "Amen." And a young boy said, "Sir, my daddy went to war and didn't make it back. Would you take a picture standing here with me? And maybe let me wear your army hat?" Every eye was on him, There was not a dry one in the crowd. They whispered and they pointed as Grandpa stood up extra tall and proud. He said, "Son, just keep it." When the young boy tried his best to give it back, "You're a brave little soldier, son, and every soldier needs his very own authentic army hat. For your daddy who gave everything, the least that I can do is pass on this old worn-out army hat. Yes, the least that I can do is pass on this old worn-out army hat." Korean War, when Patti Page released her biggest blockbuster hit, The Tennessee Waltz. It was a favorite overseas as well as back here at home, and I thought you might enjoy it today. I was dancing with my darling to the Tennessee Waltz when a good friend I happened to see. I introduced her to my darling, and while they were dancing, my friend stole my sweetheart from me. Just how much I have lost. Yes, I lost my little darling the night the band was playing that beautiful Tennessee Waltz. Now I wonder how a dance like the Tennessee Waltz could have broken my heart so complete. Well, I couldn't blame my darling, 'cause who could help but falling for a love so tender and sweet. I remember that night and the Tennessee Waltz. Now I know just how I have lost. Yes, I lost my little darling the night the band was playing that beautiful Tennessee Waltz. That beautiful Tennessee. Salute. I love this grouping. And of course, we've got the Air Force, Marines, the Army, Coast Guard, and the Navy songs here today. Now, do we have any military people here? See your hands. Get them up high so I can see. Yes, yes, yes. Thank you for your service, all of you. So when we get to your song, would you please stand up and we'd like to know where you are and see you so we can address it later. But thank you for your service. And we're going to start out with the Air Force. So any airmen in here? Airmen, there we go. There we go. Oh, yeah, here we go. There we go. Off we go into the wild blue yonder, climbing high into the sun. Here they come, zooming to me. Our thunder at a voice, hear the gun. Down we dive, spouting our flame from under. Off with one heck of a roar. We live in fame or go down in fame. Nothing can stop the U.S. Air Force. Thank you, sir.
sing her song for him anyway.
From the halls of Montezuma to the shores of Tripoli, we will fight our country's battles in the air, on land and sea. First to fight for right and freedom, then to keep our honor clean. We are proud to claim the title of United States Marines.
Yeah. Okay, do we have any who served in the Army? There we go. We got some. Oh, guys. Oh, my gosh. Look at this. Wonderful. Thank you.
Over hill, over dale, we will hit the dusty trail as those caissons go rolling along. In and out, hear them shout, counter march and ride about as those caissons go rolling along. Then it's high, high, high in the field artillery. Count out your numbers loud and strong. So roll him along.
Thank you. Coast Guard's next. Coast Guard. Oh, we have one in the back. I kind of know that guy. That's my boy.
We're always ready for the call. We place our trust in thee. Through surf and storm and howling gale, how shall our purpose be? Semper Gratus is our guide, our fame and glory too. To fight, to save, or fight and die.
Aye, Coast Guard, we are for you. Thank you. Navy. Let's see the seamen. Do we have some seamen here? Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. All the way to the back. Oh, my God. Look at them over here. Hello.
Anchors away, my boys. Anchors away.
Across the heartland to Colorado, and during her trip she was amazed by the White City Exposition in Chicago, the beauty of the golden wheat fields of Kansas, and the majestic view from Pikes Peak. Her scenic trip inspired a poem which was published 2 years later to commemorate the 4th of July. By 1900, a hymn tune composed by Samuel Ward was considered the best tune from 75 different melodies that had been considered. His arrangement remains the tune that we sing today, America the Beautiful.
Yeah.
Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, for Oh, beautiful for patriots' dreams that sees beyond the years. Thine all our bastard cities gleam, undimmed by human tears. America, America, God shed his grace on thee.
Relatively new songs that I picked out for today's show is actually still 22 years old. But it seems like yesterday when I first heard it. I have loved the song, and it was one that I took down to the studio when I lived in Omaha, and my friend who was a master musician down there put a backtrack for me for this particular song. So I'd like to share that today. It's called Private Malone.
I was just out of the service, looking through the classifieds, when an ad that said Old Chevy somehow caught my eye. The lady didn't know the year or even if it ran, but I had that $1,000 in my hand. It was somewhere in the middle of this old ramshackle barn, with 30 years of dust and dirt on that red army tarp. When she took the cover off, it took away my breath, 'cause what she called a Chevy was a 66 Corvette. The glove box, that's when I found the note. The year was 1966, this is what he wrote. He said, my name is Private Andrew Malone. If you'll read this, then I didn't make it home. But for every dream that shattered, another one comes through. This car was once a dream of mine, and though you may take her and make her your own, you'll always be riding with Private Malone. Well, it didn't take me long to where I had it running good. Love to hear those horses thunder underneath the hood, and the shining like a diamond, and I'd pull the ragtop down. All the pretty girls would stare at us when we'd go through town. The buttons on the radio didn't seem to work quite right, but she'd pick up that oldie show, especially late at night. Sometimes I'd get the feeling if I'd look real quick, I'd see a soldier riding shotgun in the seat right next to me. It was a young man named Private Andrew Malone, who fought for his country but didn't make it home. But for every dream that shattered, another one comes true. This car was once a dream of his, back when it was new. He told me to take her and make her my own. I'm proud to be riding with Private Malone. One night it was raining. when they thought they saw a soldier pull me out. They didn't get his name, but I know without a doubt. For his country, but didn't make it home. But for every dream that shattered, another one comes true. This car was once a dream of his, back when it was new. I know I wouldn't be here if he hadn't tagged along. Thank God I was riding with Brian alone.
Thank you. That's a song I wish that I had written. Now, the next up, some of you might recognize that flag. And for those of you who are not familiar with it, it has a little story that goes with it. The Blue Star, it's called the Blue Star Service Flag, or the Blue Star Banner, and it was very popular in World War I. It started then. This flag was with the Blue Star, was and can be displayed in the window of a home when a family member is serving in the U.S. Armed Forces. Now, a gold star in the window represents a family member who has died during military operations. Now, this is the service flag, this mine, and it was a gift from my four boys when they all entered the service. They were all part of the service at the same time for just a little while, and they gave me this flag. As of this year, as of May, all the boys have completed their military commitment. Now, I wrote the song Four Stars when I first received the flag. The song went to number one on the music to radio charts. So I hope you enjoy this song. It's called Four Stars.
There's a flag in my window. It's a flag I'm proud to show. Four stars of blue have special meaning, and I want the world to know. This flag is not like any other. It stands for freedom and even more. One star for each son, for every daughter who fights our fight in times of war. So wave all glory, wave her proudly, wave her high for all to see, and ask the Lord for his sweet blessings, and bring him safely to me. They were once my little children, with hopes and dreams all of their own. They chose to serve this mighty nation in a time of peace or a combat zone. And to those stars are golden, we thank you for your sacrifice, for your fallen son or daughter who fought for us and gave their lives. So wave all glory, wave her proudly, wave her high to me and bring them safely home to me. And they all are stars in blue. And he brought them home to me.
End of the show. So, okay. I can turn that off. We're coming to the end of the show, and before we wind everything up, I'd like to take a moment to thank all the staff. They are just really great when they come. They help me bring it in and set it up. And also, you see all their names up there, and then also the people behind the shows that make it work. And then my sister, who's here doing the PowerPoint, I thank her. And also to you, who took time out of this precious holiday to come out to the show today. So we're going to end with God Bless America. And after, it has that little beginning to it. And then God Bless America. And then it repeats one more time there, if you're so inclined to sing along. That's where it's going. So the God Bless America is twice. So now I'll turn it up.
As the storm clouds gather, far across the sea, let us pledge allegiance this land that's free. Let us all be grateful for this land so fair. As we raise our voices in this solemn prayer,